All right. Good morning. Good morning. I know we're all here, and we just the rules: no flash photography, no videography. We're all good. We have our photographers here to take pictures. We're gonna have a little meet and greet after, or like just say hi, mahalo, thank you for coming. Are you guys excited to be here? You can draw if you can, and if get this good side of me. Oh, you're not drawing me? Shucks. Just kidding. By the way, I'm Sweetie Picaro. Welcome. Good morning. Good morning. Happy New Year. It's already February. Whatever. It is February, right? Valentine's Day is coming. I'm so lost with time. Happy New Year. Yeah. Any Valentine's celebrations going on? Just kidding. So, bathrooms, you all know where the restrooms are? Yes. Feel free to walk into any bathroom that you want. I'm just kidding. Just kidding. The men's room are... To my left. What? Your right. Okay, here. And then the women, it's to our right when you walk out of this maze. Don't get lost. You might never be found. Seriously. You think I'm joking? Had some people from last year's show. No, I'm kidding. Just kidding. Eat, drink, be merry. Welcome, welcome. We're going to start in just a second, and I'm going to just show you. I think, Auntie Karen, do we have the applause sign? Oh, right behind you. I'm going to warm up. Anytime you see this applause sign waving in the air, our high-tech, fancy applause sign, if you see it like this, upside down, whatever, if you see this flapping, just applause. So I'm going to just go, ladies and gentlemen, it's Michael W. Perry and Karen Kiavi Hawaii. Mike, I'm sorry. Sorry.
Then, can you applause upside down?
Yeah. Then you gotta go when you see it upside down. You gotta go. No, I'm kidding. Well, I wasn't sure if I was gonna get back up from that. But anyway, let's try it one more time. Ready? Ladies and gentlemen, it's Michael W. Perry and Karen Kiavi Hawaii. I think because I'm whispering, but I'm trying to save my voice. No, I'm kidding. It's our Valentine's Day show coming up on Saturday, so if you haven't come to our show, come now. It's a good one. Roses for everybody from Watanabe Floral.
Yeah.
Okay. You may win a trip to Vegas. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Vegas, baby. So come visit us. It's lots of fun, great entertainment. Always good. Okay, we ready? Michael's going to talk to you now because I took up just a little short piece of your time. All right.
Hey, guys.
Here's your applause sign.
That's my job.
That's her job. We have Jimmy. We're in touch with Jimmy here back in the studio, I think. Hi, Jimmy. Wait. Say again. Yeah, it's pretty bad. How come I can't hear him?
Can hear Julia.
He was doing too much basketball last night.
Nope. Not volume. Gotta be better than that.
In a world where my microphone doesn't work.
It doesn't. That's all right. Okay, so we'll get Jimmy's here, and I think we can start. If you do a jingle out of Julia, I think we can do it right then, okay? This is boring radio stuff. I'm sorry. We have to figure out how we're going to get this in here. And then everybody knows you're on TV, right? You realize you're on TV. Is there anyone here with someone they shouldn't be here with? You're so busted.
I know. Oh, you noticed.
Or if you
not
called
busty.
In sick.
So here's the deal. We have Mark Cohn. Big round of applause when he comes in, okay? Big Mark
hello,
Cohn.
Hello.
There you go.
You
whatever you did. Say hi to everybody, Jimmy.
Hi, everybody.
That's Jimmy the Geek Bender. He is the guy you see every day on OC16 with every local sports thing possible. And we're good to go. Okay, we got a jingle coming out of this. You got this.
We're about 3 minutes out.
Perfect. And is it who we got back there? Coop?
Yep.
Hi, it's Coop. He's the big round of applause for Coop. He the man. Do you have any questions?
Do we have, if you have questions?
If you have any questions for Mark,
we'll be taking them.
Interesting guy, interesting stories. He's got quite a life.
Raise your hand if you will. You have a story? You have, of course, you have one. Anybody else? Anybody else? Al, you have a question? No, you're good. Question? No. You have a question. You have a question? No. You're like, no way. Hey, I'm just looking at my phone. Don't even bother me. Freaking me out right now. No, I'm kidding. You have a question right here. You're like, heart attack going on. No, no, we're good. No questions? Just, okay, good. Excited is good. Really? I went to Memphis, too, and I was, yes.
Tiff?
Isn't it awesome?
I have time for four or might be five. I'm not sure. Depends on how the spot load is. Four? Okay.
She went to Memphis. Is that anywhere close to Liliha?
Almost close.
Is there anybody here who's never been to the music hall before? Any music hall virgins? You? Oh, you too. Terrific. Welcome. Kind of comfy, isn't it? This is a very nice place. This is our boss's idea was to turn this used to be a storage room. We were all afraid to come in because it was haunted.
I'm just curious.
Yes?
Why did they take down all my pictures?
Sorry about that. Oh, yeah. It was in the dark. It used to be lined with Karen pictures.
Yes, thank you.
Our shrine. She felt betrayed by her husband's support for Trump.
You're everywhere.
Amazing, isn't it? So what we'll try to do is, when you see the, you got the applause sign over there? When you see the applause sign flapping in the breeze, you know what to do. And what we'll try to do is time this so it comes out right. We'll have to do a couple of live commercials here. You'll be part of them, which is good. Congratulations. And you'll get the usual check in the mail. Let's see, we have
30 seconds.
30 seconds it is. Thanks, Jim. Ladies and gentlemen, right here, see this gentleman in the KSSK jacket? He is America's only Portuguese chief radio station engineer, Dale Mayawat Machado. Dale's getting ready for the onslaught of live shows we're going to be doing. We're going to be
5 seconds.
Three cruises and one Vegas this year. Holy cow. There we go. Raise that sound. Woohoo! All right. We're in the music hall. Ladies and gentlemen, Karen Kaave Hawaii.
Mahalo, Michael W. Perry.
And we are here with a bunch of people, very lucky people. Oh, and ladies and gentlemen, Sweetie Picaro.
Good morning.
She's got a microphone, too. We are here with a bunch of people who were lucky enough to win on the radio a chance to come by our music hall and see a private concert. Kind of a cushy place to have a concert, isn't it? Get that lady on tape, because we definitely want her. The testimonial on how nice it is in here. We have a broadcast coming to you specifically because a couple of sponsors have gotten involved with this and made it possible.
And they are?
I was hoping you'd tell me.
Anamora Pepper.
Oh, you know, Anamora.
Oh, our sponsors today, pay attention because there will be a test after this, okay?
And a pepper.
Okay, Oceanic Time Warner Cable.
Yes.
Hawaiian Springs Water.
Thank you, Water People.
And Blue Note Hawaii.
Which is where the performances will be. The guy you're about to hear on the radio is at the Blue Note now through Saturday. Ladies and gentlemen, he's an incredible Grammy Award winning singer-songwriter. Big Hawaii welcome for Mr. Mark Cohn. He walks in. Hey, Mark. He has his lay on.
He is Hawaii.
Congratulations. We gave you a complimentary lay and a Mai Tai on the way in, right?
There was a couple of Mai Tais.
Welcome to Hawaii, by the way.
Thank you very much. It's great to be here.
Have you ever performed in Hawaii before? Have you done?
This is it. First time. Oh. Two shows, Monday, Tuesday, were my first.
A Hawaii virgin performer. This is wonderful. Good to have you here. We'll just kick this off because he is a great singer. What a voice. What a voice and what a story. We'll get into the story and have your Niele questions for him coming up later. Please welcome Mark Cohn to our stage in the Oceanic Music Hall.
Thank you.
Walk through this world with me.
Mark Cohn. Here in our Oceanic Music Hall, it's Michael W. Perry.
Karen Kevin Hoy.
Coming right back after this. As we pause for an endless commercial break.
Okay. That's all right.
We'll ask you, we have a question? Okay, we'll get to a question. Maybe after another song. I will focus on early life.
And, oh boy.
Studio musicianship, okay?
Okay.
We'll do that.
Sure.
I'm Mike. This is Karen, by the way.
Aloha.
Hi, Karen.
We've never met.
The two of you?
No, we've us? Never seen each other before, no.
Yeah, this is our first time.
I'm your child.
Oh, my. Oh,
it's
my
our love
God.
Child back in the day.
It was a difficult delivery.
That's sweetie, and
we do a live. Have to cut this concert short.
But why?
For your own safety.
For my own safety.
How long is Mark here?
Through Saturday.
Al, you know these things? No.
I do.
Kristen, huh? Through Saturday night. Okay.
Two shows a night.
At the Blue Note, two at shows.
Yes. Should I not play?
Yeah, we should tell them about two shows a night at the Blue Note.
Oh, okay. Good. Okay, cool. Are there any requests aside from Memphis?
Silver Thunderbird.
Silver Thunderbird? Okay.
Silver Thunderbird. You got. There's a Silver Thunderbird fan right there.
Okay. Okay. All right. Got it.
About 30 seconds, I'm going to jingle to you after the weather stuff.
Thanks, Jim.
You're going to tinkle to us? Hearing goes bad, sorry. But I look good. Yes, no?
Marvelous.
I look marvelous.
Good hair.
Good hair, you want it after?
Do you know she makes these flowers?
She makes these flowers,
and there's a website you can actually buy them. Looks like real flowers.
I don't make the trees.
No.
Spontaneous applause. I love it.
We love it. Karen Calvi, Hawaii.
Michael W. Perry.
Sweetie Picaro. And we are here with Mark Cohn in the we're in the Oceanic Music Hall down the hall, just past the men's room from all of our studios and everything with Mark. This is his first trip to Hawaii to perform, and it's been a long time coming.
I'd like to explain something to Mr. Cohn.
Sure.
And that is, before we went into his first number, you said we're going to have questions from the people who are here and who are ni'ele.
Mm-hmm.
This being his first time to Hawaii, we should explain ni'ele.
Explain it.
Explain.
Go ahead.
Ni'ele, Mr. Cohn.
Yes, I'm listening.
Very nosy.
Oh, really?
KSSK listeners are remarkably nosy people. They like to know things.
Okay.
As a matter of fact, this person over here probably has a question, whoever that was. Hi, name and where are you from?
It's Carol from Palolo.
Uh-huh.
What is your most memorable or pivotal moment in your quite extensive musical journey?
My favorite memory, maybe, do you mean?
Yes.
Well, I've been lucky enough to have a bunch of those. I mean, I've opened shows and done shows with some of my heroes. But one particular concert sticks out for me over the years. I was opening up for Crosby, Stills, and Nash years ago, and there's a song of mine called Perfect Love, which James Taylor sang on the record, a background part. So that in and of itself was thrilling because he's one of my all-time heroes. But at this concert in L.A. where I opened for Crosby, Stills, and Nash, some quote-unquote friends came by to visit, and I wasn't expecting, when I turned around, my background choir surprised me and started singing James's part in harmony. And it was David Crosby, Graham Nash, Jackson Browne, and Bonnie Raitt.
Oh, yeah.
The four of them were my background choir.
Best backup singers of all time.
The greatest. All of whom have become close friends and mentors. So that's one of the great thrills of what I've done, is not only to be able to perform with those great people, but to befriend them and have them part of my life. They're wonderful people, too.
Mark Cohn's at the Blue Note this week, of course.
On two shows nightly till Saturday.
Isn't yes. that nice?
Yeah.
And the Blue Note is a great venue, by the way. You're listening to this on KSSK, AM and FM, and on iHeartRadio all over the world, of course. And if you can't see right now, it's on video, too. It's Mark and his piano. You started out with guitar, though, didn't you?
Yeah, that was my first instrument.
And what, boy band when you were in school or what?
I had a rock band. You know, we did Maggie May and Bad Company songs for a couple of years. I was singing next to a friend at a locker in a high school, and he said, "I think you're a singer. Why don't you join my band?" And I did. That
you
was
attended
the first time
Beechwood,
I sang.
High
Beechwood,
school.
Beechwood, Ohio. That's
yeah.
right. You guys did your research.
Well, we try. 44122.
She knows all zip codes.
Wow.
Did she get it right?
I think so.
Yeah, of course.
Let me check it out. I'll go right to him. Wow. That's cool. Yeah.
We have Mark Cohn on stage here at KSSK and, of course, at the Blue Note. And we have a lot of lucky people who are watching. Want to do another song?
Sure. Well, somebody asked for this song in the audience. This is a song I wrote about my old man who was 60 when I was born. But when he got in his car, he was something approaching cool. Watch it coming up Winslow, down South Park Boulevard. Yeah, it was looking good from tail to hood. Great big fins and painted steel. It looked just like the Batmobile. With my old man behind the wheel. Yeah, you could hardly even see him in all of that chrome. The man with the plan and the pocket comb. But every night it carried him home. I could hear him say, "Don't you give me no Buick. Son, you gotta take my word. If there's a God in heaven, got a silver thunderbird. You could keep your Eldorado. Yeah, my foreign car's absurd. Me, I want to go down in a silver thunderbird." But he got up every morning while I was still asleep. But I remember the sound of him shuffling around. Right before the crack of dawn, I heard him turn the motor on. But when I got up, they were gone. Down the road in the rain and snow, the man and his machine would go. The secrets that that old car would know. Sometimes I hear him say, "Don't you give me no beauty. Son, you got to take my word. If there's a God in heaven, he's got a silver thunderbird. And you could keep your Eldorados. Yeah, and the foreign car's absurd. Me, I like to go down in silver thunderbird." Hey, yeah. Hey, yeah. It was down the road in the rain and snow. The man in his machine would go. The secrets that old car would know. "Don't you give me no beauty. Son, take my word. If there's a God up in heaven, he's got a silver thunderbird. And you could keep your Eldorados. Yeah, and the phone.
I want to go down in a silver thunderbird. Me, I want to go down in a silver thunderbird.
Mark Cohn. At the Blue Note, through Saturday.
Two shows tonight, don't forget, call them.
We'll be right back after this.
Thank you.
We'll come to Chuck. Chuck's still here, right? We'll come to Chuck just for a second. Sure, tell us why.
Mr. Cohn might leave the stage.
What?
What?
You can explain it to him. Yeah, yeah. In a soft way.
Why might I leave the stage? That sounds compelling.
I have to tell you, though.
Yes.
That song,
yes.
We were all in that vehicle. That's very nice. Nice.
Thank you. 0039
or AlohaLaserVision.com. Aloha from let's bury it in the middle, okay? Okay.
Thank you.
And next stop, Zippies, is the queue. Karen, are you a dog or a cat person?
I are a dog person.
Lucky you said that, because
yes.
Zippy's Restaurants has a Zip Dog with pastrami.
Ooh.
Oh.
And
the Zip Dog with pastrami. Would you folks like to know what's in it?
Yes.
Pastrami.
and a dog. No, it's actually, there's a Frankfurter in there. It's Zippy's famous chili over that. Then there's the cheddar cheese.
Yeah, and it. You know, I believe in vegetables, so there's lettuce.
That's one of the food groups.
Yeah.
And pastrami.
Yeah.
Okay?
Okay.
All wrapped up in a warm tortilla.
Okay.
You got so many little ethnic things going on there, it's almost confusing. But pastrami, tortillas, and Zippy's chili all in one thing with a hot dog.
Don't you think it's a hearty handful of satisfying your appetite?
I was about to say that.
See how quick I are?
That's pretty good. The Zip Dog with pastrami is available only for a limited time. So grab a Zip Dog when you make your next stop.
At Zippy's.
Of course.
Was that E-flat?
That commercial inspired me. I feel a song coming on.
And what's the commercial right after the Zip Dog? Queens Medical Center.
Get your cardiologist.
I did.
Get your call.
I did. Yeah. I'm all good for Vegas.
But it is really good. That's so cool. Absolutely.
Who's our sponsor?
30 seconds.
Thanks, Jim.
We're good.
Very.
We're rehearsing.
You're pros.
We're totally on it.
Yeah.
We show up.
We show up.
That's half of it right there.
Here comes the jingle.
I live for that.
Oh, what a posse it is, too. We got Karen Cavi, Hawaii.
Michael W. Perry.
And
Sweetie Picaro.
We're here with Mark Cohn from Blue Note. Mark is from Ohio via L.A., I guess, right?
L.A. and New York City is where I live now.
Mark Cohn was—he started playing guitar very early, but
taught himself guitar, taught himself piano, taught himself songwriting. We all heard his playing. My God, I could sit at a piano for the rest of my life and not be able to do that.
The oddest part about it is, if you put sheet music to one of my songs in front of me, I wouldn't know what it was.
couldn't play it.
Yeah.
Seeing how what we say we play by ear.
That's right.
It's really difficult.
I was lucky. Oh, I see what you mean. You're actually literally playing.
She has very tiny ears, and it just doesn't.
I think it was. It's a figure of speech.
That would be it.
Yes. Quite so. When you finally taught yourself piano and were in the band in high school and everything, you ended up being a backup piano. By the way, during the break, Honolulu Ford sold 4 Silver Thunderbirds. And here's the guy I wanted to hear. Your dad actually bought one, right, sir?
Yeah, that song reminds me a lot of my father. Back in the early 90s, when Thunderbird came out with the anniversary edition, he spent more on that car than he spent on the house that I grew up in.
Yeah, sounds familiar.
His wasn't silver, it was black. It was one of the anniversary editions. But every time I hear that song, I can picture my father just flying down the street.
Yeah. That's great. That's fantastic.
So you ended up a Silver Thunderbird. You drove down and became a studio musician in Los Angeles.
In New York. I started to get work as a singer on other people's songs, demos, and things like that.
Movies. Okay, now that a studio musician, as we know, is one of the most interesting jobs in the world because you get to see all these famous people being real.
But this was a threshold for a lot of the famous people.
Oh, yeah?
You know?
There were a lot of people that did studio work, yeah.
This was after college?
This was after college, yeah, when I was around 25. Yeah.
So dish some dirt for us on some famous people that you were in the studio with who were either just great or absolute idiots.
No idiots. I mean, I was lucky enough to be surrounded by some amazing songwriters. The person I was proudest to have to play piano on a record of was Tracy Chapman.
Oh, yeah.
And she was fantastic. I mean, lovely woman, brilliantly talented, still putting out great records, too. Wow. Nobody knows them, but they're great. They're great.
Blue Note is where he's going to be. This week, only through Saturday, Mark is at the Blue Note, which is just an incredible venue. Isn't that a wonderful place?
Great, intimate place, yeah.
And once again, there are 2 shows. 6:30 is the first show, and then 6:35 is the next show. Ah, just kidding. 9:00. 6:30.
Everybody in.
Those are my shows.
Everybody out.
Yeah.
You've been to the Blue Note in Greenwich Village, right?
I have.
Which is, who did we see there? Who do we see, Megawatt, when we were there on our cruise?
I think I just finished my tour there.
I wasn't there with you. I'm mad now.
But, yeah.
First time I played a Blue Note, though. I never played that one.
The great entertainers absolutely come through the Blue Note, and that's where you can see Mark this week.
And you know who's killing me right now at home?
Who that?
Shaw.
Why?
Because she handles a lot of the acts music-wise for the Blue Note. Oh. And she goes, Karen! Not 6:30 to 6:35.
What's actually 6:30 and?
9.
There we go. Yeah. Tickets still on sale for Mark. And he's got CDs and all that stuff, of course. One more song?
Sure. Just one more for
No.
Oh, okay.
Plenty more time.
Okay. Also by request, this is a lot of people's wedding song. Well, baby, I've been searching like everybody else. I can't say nothing different about myself. Sometimes I'm an angel and sometimes I'm cruel. When it comes to love, I'm just another fool. I'll climb a mountain, I'm gonna swim the sea. There ain't no act of God, girl, it's gonna keep you safe. You know my arms are reaching out across this canyon. I'm asking you to be my true companion. Be my true companion. So don't you dare
bitch had to walk away. I got my heart set on our wedding day. I got this vision of a girl in white, and I made my decision that it's you, alright. And when I take your hand, gonna watch my heart set sail. Gonna take my trembling fingers, then I'll lift up your veil. Then I'm gonna take you home. Yeah, with wild abandon, I made love to you just like a true companion. Like a true companion, you're my true companion. And when the years have done irreparable harm, I can see us walking slow. Maybe like that couple on the corner do. Because girl, I will always be in love with you when I look in your eyes. I'm still gonna see that spark till all these shadows fall, till even this room grows dark. Even when I leave this earth, I'll be with the angels standing. I'll be out there waiting on my true companion. Just for my true companion. I got a true companion. I got a true.
Mike?
Yep.
Can I have Mark come home with me and sing that to Jackie?
It'll cost you. But yes, he's available. He does weddings and just...
He does do weddings. If I'm not mistaken, didn't you perform at Caroline Kennedy's wedding?
I did. I performed at Caroline Kennedy's wedding, and I played that song at Andre Agassi's first wedding. Yeah, I've done that song a few times for people.
And you can sing it to my husband. I'll pay you $1 a pound. That's how much I get paid.
That's very enticing.
I get paid big bucks.
Yeah.
And on your case, not so much. So tiny.
How could I refuse?
Thank you so much.
Mark Cohen at the Blue Note, coming right back with more from the Oceanic Music Hall at KSSK.
Yes.
You want another live?
New kind of fun.
Yeah. We can do the cruise. Let's do the cruise spot.
Yeah, should I apologize to him already?
No.
I'll bury it in the middle of the set. We'll have an obvious out cue.
About 1 minute right after the
iHeartRadio promo. Everyone deserves an ocean view.
Oh my God.
Wow. For how long?
January of 1983.
Wow.
Before that, you could go to Kona, and it was an absolutely beautiful place with clear air. Huh. And then all of a sudden, in 1983, strangely enough, that's when Coach and I went on the volcano started spewing hot gas at the same time, if you can believe it.
So I cannot take credit.
That's pretty funny.
Do you realize Karen Cavey, Hawaii, and Sweetie, do you realize we're going on a cruise?
Yes, Michael W. Perry.
Yes.
And we actually have three cruises this year. Nonstop travel is, but that's okay. One of them sold out. One of them's almost sold out. Handful of cabins for Alaska. The East Coast cruise, still some cabins available. That's in October. But we're already booking summer of 2018.
Woo! Isn't that something? Yeah.
Would you like to be on that cruise with us? Yes. Well, then call Nonstop Travel quick and pay for
and
it.
Tell them Michael sent you.
That's right. It's a brand new ship. Norwegian Bliss is the name of the ship. It's not even built yet. They're building it. Guess who is doing the hull painting? Weiland.
Yep.
Weiland is doing the hull on this design for Alaska. Huge ship. Absolutely spectacular. Here's the deal. If you want a cruise, book early. That's where you get the best deals. So I know it's hard to put in your day plan or something for 2018, but you got to. All right? Here's the deal.
Yes.
Two spectacular bonuses.
Ooh.
Ultimate beverage package with gratuities, unlimited cocktail wines and beers.
That's Mike's favorite.
Should we say that again? Unlimited cocktails, wines, and beers. And four specialty restaurant packages with gratuities.
Yeah. Aaron's favorite.
You know what that's worth?
$1,658.
Per person.
Per.
Free if you book now. And as a matter of fact, if you book now with Nonstop, you can actually save another $150 a person. But only Nonstop Travel's got this. Our pals.
They're the amazing guys.
Yep. Gene, Lisa, all the gang there. Danny, the owner, Danny.
Call now, though, because cabins are very limited on this one. Everybody wants to be on that cruise. It's one of the first cruises for Norwegian Bliss. Here's the number, 593-0700, 593-0700. Coming right back from the Oceanic Music Hall.
We love Kia.
Talk about your carjacking.
Carjacking.
Which is just the weirdest story of all time.
That's pretty strange.
And we have one more song? Is that one more? Okay, anybody got another question? What? One through?
No, I'm kidding. As she walked through Memphis, she sang. Everybody does that, right?
I sing that song.
Because I did it, too. I just went to Memphis, and I sang that song the whole time I walked.
Well, of course.
It's kind of crazy, but you do it.
Hey, so where's your boy going to
sing? Thank goodness.
Right?
Well, let's end. We'll do the story, and then we'll end with her.
And I have to tell Mr. Cohn something else. I perform once in a while with the Royal Hawaiian Band here in Hawaii, and every single musician there is jealous that I get to spend part of my morning with you.
Oh, that's
very
sweet.
They're performing now, but they're like, damn.
The musicians, tell them I said musician.
Hawaiians say that wonderful word, damn.
Right?
What time was I here this morning?
Yeah, 6 o'clock.
Yeah.
6 o'clock. She's early for everything. It's just it's.
And I can't find. Okay.
What?
I'm good.
We have Mark Cohn with us. Mark Cohn is the guy who's not only at the Blue Note through Saturday.
Mm-hmm. Two shows.
6 o'clock and.
6:30.
6:30 and 9 o'clock.
6:30 and 9 o'clock. Got yes. it. Tickets still on sale for Blue Note. He's on our stage here in the Oceanic Music Hall. I don't know if it was on Ellen where I first heard the story. About what happened to you, I think it might have been on Ellen. You were on the Ellen DeGeneres yeah. show or something, mm-hmm. telling the story about your carjacking experience.
Yeah, I had a difficult day in Denver about 10 years ago. I did a gig at a beautiful venue called the Botanic Gardens, one of my favorite places to play, where everybody is sitting around you in a circle. And it was just, I was at the wrong place at the wrong time. My band and I were driving back from the gig to our hotel, and there was a man, high as it turns out, on crystal meth, who wanted our car to get out of town for other reasons. He had already broken the law a couple of times, I think. And I was the first one who saw that when he stood right in front of our car to try to get it, that he had a gun. And he shot it through the windshield. And that slowed down the bullet just enough to graze my tour manager's chin and then hit me in the left temple, where unbelievably I remained conscious while I watched them take the bullet out. Didn't kill me, obviously, didn't do any physical damage, but it took a while to get over the psychological trauma of that. Unbelievably, ever since that event, you would think I would stay away from the road, but after I worked through some of the post-traumatic stress, I've never played more, and I've released a bunch of records since then, too. So, blessing and a curse.
What a recovery. Woo! What a recovery. Jeez.
Thank you.
You're the man.
I think I'm a survivor.
Do you go back to Denver ever?
All the time. All the time.
Really?
The first time I went back after the shooting, Denver felt really bad about it. They were so apologetic. They were like, we're so sorry this happened in Denver. And I was like, well, if it happened in Cleveland, it would have been okay. But the loveliest thing was my first concert back, I was reminded of this great scene in a movie called The World According to Garp with Robin Williams. And he's looking for houses, and the realtor is showing him around this house, and he's not so sure about it. And while the realtor is showing him the house, a plane comes from out of the sky, crashes right into the house, and he looks at the realtor and says, I'll take it. And she says, what do you mean you'll take it? He said, well, that's never going to happen again. So going back to Denver is like that for me. What are the chances anything bad's going to happen?
And yet he has not written a song entitled Walking in Denver.
No. No.
We do have questions, though, from a young lady who loves that song and everything. Hi, name and where you're from.
My name's Ray, and I'm from Honolulu. And
Hi, Ray.
I got a chance to go to Nashville for a business trip a few years ago. So a friend and I, we rented a car and went down to Memphis, and we went to every place we could find in that song. And, you know, the whole catfish on the table and everything, you know, we did everything we could just because, I mean, and I don't know what it is about the song, but it just really... You know, it just kind of gets in your heart, you know, and so I just wonder, are there other places that you're going to write those songs about? Because it's just amazing.
It's a mystery, Ray. You don't know. I mean, I went there looking for inspiration, but I was even surprised by how moved everybody else was by that song, because it was just a personal story of mine. And luckily it resonated. That's what you're hoping for, that something is so personal that it's also universal.
Karen, is there some place here that he would be inspired by?
I think he should go to Kalihi.
Walking in Kalihi.
You wouldn't have to walk too far. It's a very limited walk.
It's Kalihi?
No catfish for you there.
Other people call it Kalihi. But Kalihi is,
it's over there. And we can take you there if you like, right after one of your Blue Note performances. Yeah.
You'll talk about chicken adobo and all that.
Yeah, really. You'll learn Hawaii, right?
These are inside jokes. I don't know what's going on right now.
You can
but
park
I'm smiling like a good sport.
Mark, you can park your car anywhere in Kalihi, yeah? Leave your car unlocked, the hood up, the trunk up, and then nobody will get busted.
Can I ask you a question?
Sure you can.
What's the zip code?
96817.
Thank you.
You can't stop her. It can't be done. Tell you what, let's finish off with the song from Mark Cohn, Mr. Singer-Songwriter. And we're so glad to have you in Hawaii finally.
Thank you. It's great to be here.
At the Blue Note.
Thank you. This is for Ray. Feel free to sing along if you want.
Does this mean you're going home with Ray?
Not.
Put on my blue suede shoes and aborted the plane. Touched down in the land of the Delta Blues in the middle of the pouring rain. W.C. Handy, won't you look down over me? Yeah, I got a first class ticket, but I'm as blue as a boy could be. Then I'm walking in Memphis, walking with my feet 10 feet off a beam. Walking in Memphis, but do I really feel the way I feel? followed him up to the gates of Graceland. Man, I watched him walk right through. Now security did not see him. They just hovered around his tomb. But there's a pretty little thing waiting for the king. She ran down in the jungle room, walking in Memphis, walking with my feet 10 feet off a beam, walking in Memphis. But do I really feel the way I feel? They got some catfish on the table. They got gospel in the air. And Reverend Green, he'd be glad to see you. When you have not got a prayer. I lost that note into the blue note. Boy, they got a prayer in Memphis. Now Muriel, she plays piano every Friday down at Hollywood. And they brought me down. And then they asked me if I would do a little number, and I said with all of my might. She said, tell me, are you a Christian child? And I said, ma'am, I am. Tonight, walking in Memphis, I was walking with my feet 10 feet off. I really feel the way I feel. Put on my blue suede shoes and I boarded the plane. Touched down in the land of the Delta Blues, in the middle of the pouring rain. I touched down in the land. The land of the Delta Blues, in the middle of the pouring down rain.
Thank you.
He's at the Blue Note. And, of course, Grammy Award winner at the Blue Note. Two shows, 6:30 and 9.
And if you want reservations, call 777-4890. Magic number.
Oh, it certainly is. Mark, thank you very much. Enjoy
thank
Hawaii.
You. It was a great time. Thanks a lot, everybody.
Come back.
Mark Cohn at the Blue Note right now on KSSK.
And we thank
you. Thank you.
And it's going to take months to close on a home. You have nothing to lose here. Call American Financing at 638-4798. They have an
Hi everyone, for the meet and greet questions, we're going to light up here. We already have free sign posters, and then the only photos that are allowed is our professional camera. It'll be uploaded on our website tomorrow, so you guys can grab it from there. Love you, thank you, hope you guys enjoyed it.
How was the